Hi, nice to meet you. Today I'm going to be your doctor. And if the nurse told me correctly, you're just here for a physical exam, right? Okay, great. Right, now if you have any concerns, health concerns, mental concerns, anything you would like to talk to me about, I want you to feel open and willing to just share whatever with me. This is a very safe place, okay? All right, so. All right. Now, I wanted to ask you just some basic health questions. Before we get started, and please be very honest with me. I would like to get an accurate representation of your overall well-being. This will help us prevent any future health issues as well as address any current health issues that we might find, okay? Okay, so I just wanted to ask, how often do you exercise? Not that often. All right, that's fine. How often would you say? Can be once a month. You don't even remember last time you exercised. Anything like that. Okay, that's perfectly fine. Said this is a no judgment zone. I can give you some tips about how to increase your level of fitness and also help motivate you to do more exercise as well. And you can also do the exercise that you like to do. You don't necessarily have to go jogging or run a mile or something like that. You can also lift weights or do more walking, any of that counts. Okay? Alright, so how would you say your overall diet is? Do you eat plenty of fruits and vegetables? Okay. Lots of meat? And how many fruits and vegetables would you say you eat in a day? Okay, so sometimes you get the adequate amount, most days you don't. That's fine. That's very common. Most people don't get the right amount of fiber in their daytime, and that can really affect your digestive tract. So if you've been having any digestive issues or anything like that, that could be because you need a bit more fiber in your diet. And you can also get fiber from whole grains, such as whole grain bread, whole grain pasta, and stuff like that. Seems like you're getting enough protein, which is good. And do you smoke? Okay. And how many drinks would you say you have in a week if you do drink? Seems about normal. do you drink enough water during the daytime? How much liquid do you drink, let's say? Okay. Occasional soda. All right. And how about coffee? How much coffee do you drink? Usually one in the morning? Okay. Sometimes in the afternoon? And how are you sleeping? Are you sleeping okay? So you have some problems with insomnia. All right. You know, I can refer you to a specialist for your insomnia. Typically, we like to do some tests about how your day-to-day life is, and that is able to diagnose what problems you have sleeping. Typically, you know, if you have a TV in your bedroom, that can greatly affect your sleeping. Or if you use your phone or a computer an hour before you sleep, that can also really affect your ability to fall asleep naturally. But I have a really great specialist that you can see, and I think she can definitely help you fall asleep, okay? All right. Okay, now I would like to ask a couple questions about how you're feeling mentally and emotionally, okay? So, have you been feeling any extra stress or mental exhaustion lately? Mm-hmm. Okay. So, you have been feeling some extra stress lately. You know, a lot of times stress can really affect our bodies, affect our just overall well-being. Stress can manifest in physical ailments, headaches, digestive issues, heart problems, everything like that. So since you are experiencing some extra stress, I am really going to recommend that you see our sleep specialist. I think she's really going to be able to help you deal with that stress in a way that you're going to feel more at least rested every day. And when you have a lack of sleep, that can also elevate your stress level. Now I wanted to ask, have you experienced any job change or loss or any big life change recently? All right. And like within the past month or so, or whenever the stress started to really affect you? All right. So any big life changes can really add an extra level of stress. So what I'm going to do right now is just check out your overall well-being, overall body, and see if we find anything, and just make sure that we're ready to prevent any future conditions. And a physical routine physical exam is great in finding conditions that haven't really presented themselves yet to you. So, First thing I'm going to do is I'm going to check your blood pressure. And I like to put on gloves when I do my physical exams because I don't want to pass any germs on to you that I may have. So first let me put my gloves on. I have a brand new box. Very excited to get to use. Don't mind, I'm gonna slide a little bit closer to you and just make sure that we can get your blood pressure going right now. Show that I'm keeping accurate data. So. Right. Now, if you would just put your arm out to the side right here. Thank you. Make sure that this is nice and secure on your arm. Now here we go. You're gonna feel a little bit of tightness on your arm. Don't be alarmed by it at all. Blood pressure looks completely normal. Make sure that it's deflated. Okay, that's a great sign. Your blood pressure. It's very normal. Now, I'm going to check on your heart rate, your resting heart rate. So I want you to just stay seated right where you are. Just put out your arm like you just did for me. Your heart rate is also very normal. Store the blood pressure cuff in, and then I'm going to check your breathing and your lungs. That way we can see if there's any obstructions or anything abnormal going on in there. And I could also listen to your heart and make sure that you're not having a murmur. So far, you're doing great. And right. Then we have this stored away. And just going to be listening to your heart and your lungs. So I hope you don't mind me coming close to you. So I'm just going to be coming up a little bit close to you. Don't mind my hands. Make sure that this is heated up for you. Whatever pace is comfortable. Alright, great. Now I'm coming to the other side. Take a deep breath in for me. Perfect. Reach my arm around your back and just check your back. Alright. Now take a deep breath in. Perfect. Now for the other side. Take a deep breath in for me. I'm going to listen to your heart. And I'm going to put my hand just on your shoulder here. And just breathe normally. So from what I hear, your heart is great. I didn't detect any murmur, anything like that. Have you been having any problems with your heart or lungs? Either difficulty breathing or anything like that? No? That's great. fluid or any buildup in your lungs as well. Very happy about. Looking at my clinical notebook. Alright. Now, just would like to look into your ears, and also I have a small device. I can check your temperature through your ears. I'm gonna set this up down. Look inside of your ears, and so taking your temperature from this ear. Now I'm gonna come in with my device and do a really quick temperature read. Right, normal, 98.6, perfect temperature. Now I'm gonna be looking inside your ears and just checking what I see. Now I see a little bit of fluid buildup in this ear. I'm gonna move over to your other side and take a look. If you don't mind, I'm gonna go in with a tiny little device and just clear out a little bit of that fluid. Now, you do use Q-tips? You know, that's fine. Sometimes the earwax can just get a little bit impacted inside of your ear, and it's better for us to remove it, because the more you put the Q-tip in, the more that you can actually push all that fluid inside, back inside the ear. So, I have my stuff right here, and I'm just gonna come in. Right here a little bit. Scraping the fluid out of your ear. here looks good. I'm gonna just move on to the other side of you and check out what's going on. Going to put that down, that I did a bit of an ear cleaning for you. It's good that we got to it today, because sometimes that impaction can actually cause an ear infection. So now you're all clear. Remember, like I said, don't push your Q-tips all the way inside of your ears. Just clean the outside of them. Most earwax will naturally migrate out of the ear canal and into the outer ear portion. Alright, what else should we check with you? So, I'm going to just be feeling around your neck right now. And just to make sure that you don't have any bulges or feel the overall muscular tension in those areas. Just gonna and come up to you and let's see here. Feel around your neck just a bit. Just gonna feel around your neck area. Okay. seems to be perfectly normal. Sometimes we want to just check those areas. Bulges can be signs of conditions such as low iodine or maybe something precancerous, but we are perfectly a-okay in those areas. Your strength in your shoulders and your arms. So please spread out your arms just like this for me. I agree. Now I'm going to push down on your arms and I want you to resist my pushing, okay? Alright. Great, now just relax. Perfect, and now I'm gonna push up, and I want you to resist my pushing up. Alright, great, now let me push you up, great. Alright, now stick your arms out in front of you. Alright, great, now again, just resist my hands pushing. Thing. I'm just going to push them up. Alright, great. Alright, it seems that your overall shoulder strength is good. Perfect. Now, I want you to follow my finger with your eyes. Don't move your head like this, just follow with your eyes, okay? Alright, so let's start here. Finger. Great. Eyes right here. Great. Perfect. Doing perfect with your eyes. Looks like things good. Alright. Just doing one look over again. And looks like you're in perfectly good condition. Perfectly good health condition. So I'm just going to write just going to make sure that I have it written down that you're going to go to a sleep specialist. And my nurse is going to just double check on that and make sure that you get an appointment with her ASAP. Thank you for coming to us today. We really care about your health, and we really care about making sure that you're at tip-top shape. We really want to focus on preventative care here. And if you ever have any concerns, feel free to call us, and we will either talk to you on the phone or set up an appointment with you to discuss your particular health concerns. So, as a last thing, was there anything you wanted to talk to me about? No. Alright, great. So, let me know how it goes with the sleep specialist. I really hope you can address your stress concerns as well as your insomnia, and I think that will help you reduce your stress significantly, okay? Alright, it was really excellent to meet you, and we hope to see you again soon. Not too soon though. We're happy that you're healthy.